Here is the close-up for how to insert your bobbin. So just take your fingers and slide the door toward you. By the way, do you know this door is actually a magnifying glass? That's what that little circle is. So if you need something to that's pretty small to read, there's your extra eye right there. So just take your finger and lift the bobbin out of the bobbin case area. Once again, the H on the bobbin is always up. So as you drop that in, you're gonna notice that your bobbin is gonna spin counterclockwise. That is correct. So next, bring the thread all the way down to about 6 o'clock. At 6 o'clock, there's a little groove, and the groove extends from that point up to about 7:30. And I put my finger right on here and then pull, and that clicks it right into the tension area. That is actually all it needs to have perfect tension. So if you ever see your thread just going from the bobbin, like right up through and up through the throat plate here, you can tell it's not down in this tension area. Notice as that thread came around, okay, because that's the way the bobbin was going, and then it came back, that kind of takes a hairpin turn, and that's what gives you that nice resistance as the stitches form. Next, you're gonna come over the top of this little gray area. There's a little arrow that way pointing to it, and there's an arrow pointing down here where there's a cutter under this little part. I like to put the door on next, and then pull, and then the length of the thread is held perfectly in place, and when I start to sew, that thread will be pulled up into the first stitch, so you don't have to bring that bobbin thread up. It's ready to go.